If you want to build a marriage that is established on the foundation of peace, on the foundation of harmony, joy, and love, certainly you need to click on this red button by my side. When you do that, you get subscribed, and then you become part of this move. And what is the topic we are discussing today? We are looking at the five things you must do if you must walk in each other's world. Because as partners in marriage, you need to understand one another at a deeper level. You need to be committed to improving the lives of one another. So, five things you need to do in order to find yourself walking in one another's world. Number one, anytime your spouse is at work, no matter the type of work, give him a call. It could be 5 minutes, it could be 10 minutes, but let there be an interaction between both of you. Minister to him, call him, ask him how the work is going, ask him the situation at the workplace. Let him know that you care about him. Let him know that you are part of him in the spirit. Ask him about his work. Be involved. The moment you make that call, it sends a loving signal, a compassionate signal into the heart of your spouse that you actually care, that your heart is with him or her even while at work. It makes all the difference. If you are a man or a woman in marriage, give your husband or wife a call right away. That is one of the things you must do if you must walk in each other's world. The second thing you need to do is to find out what your spouse is passionate about, what he or she loves so much, and then get involved. Does he or she love to read? I mean, maybe he or she likes to read the Bible or likes to read other materials. Once in a while you are coming back from the day's activity, get him a copy of his favorite novel. Get him a copy of his favorite book. So that, I mean, as he's going through it, I mean, you rejoice in it. So these are one of the things you need to do. Find out what he's passionate about. If it's a sporting activity, get involved. I have seen people become the fan of a particular football team, not essentially because they love the team, but because their spouse loves that team. I have seen something like that happen. I mean, especially if that team is playing another team, be passionate about it. Stand on the side of your spouse, especially when they are not playing your own team anyway. Find out what activity your spouse is passionate about. Is it something like, maybe your wife is so, she loves to cook. Why don't you find yourself in the kitchen once in a while? I mean, rejoice in the kitchen with her, pick one or two pieces of it, chew it, and in the place of laughter and everything, you get connected. There should be a connectivity between couples at that platform. Find out whatever your spouse is passionate about. Get involved. Is it swimming? Is it music? Is it movies? Get involved. The more you get involved, the more you get know one another's passions at a deeper level. Because the moment you know one another's passion and you become involved, you become one working together as one. That is what it ought to be. Then, of course, what is the third thing? If you must work together as one, if you must get to know one another's world at a deeper level, perhaps take a spiritual retreat. I have seen couples take a spiritual retreat, possibly to the mountainside. I mean, a place where the children will not be a subject of disturbance. I mean, you take a spiritual, stay together, seek the mind of God concerning you as individuals and you as a couple. Seek the mind of God together, pray together, worship together, praise God together. Learn to understand the dynamics at play in one another's life. I mean, spiritually, that is a place of also knowing one another and understanding one another's world at a deeper level. Couples must reach out to one another on the spiritual platform. It is very, very important. And what is the fourth thing that a couple ought to do to also, I mean, understand one another's world? Before I go into that fourth one, I want you to take a look at that same red button by my side. Click it. Get involved in what we are doing. We are on a race and we have just started. I tell you, many years from now, you will look back on a day like this and you will rejoice for what this channel is doing to lives. And I believe, God, that your own life will also be touched in the process. Because when it comes to relationship of marriage, divorce or separation is an aberration. It ought not to be. And certainly, it's not your own portion to divorce your wife or to divorce your husband. You are called of God to walk as one, not just for now, but until the end of your days. So I believe God that you will get that grace watching this program. So click on this red button and get involved. What is the fourth thing you must do if you must get to understand one another's word at a deeper level? Learn to study together. Study together. It could be the scripture, it could be any other thing on in the area of self-improvement. Maybe you undergo seminars together. Whatever you are doing, go together. Maybe church program or seminar or whatever makes your partner to be happy, whatever makes him or her to be lifted spiritually and physically, get involved. Study together. Learn together. Understand what makes one another joyful. Understand what makes one another excited. That is what makes you. That's how the only way you can grow as a couple. Working together, studying together, rejoicing together. So that's the fourth thing. Learn how to study together. I mean, read to one another, study together. It's very, very important if you must understand one another's word at a deeper level. And of course, finally, I have seen couples do this, and I believe it will also work good in your own relationship. Envision a particular profession or occupation that both of you can get involved. Because I see once you are working together and you are seeking solutions to problems and challenges together, there's a tendency for you to apply your emotions and work as one. So find out or envision a profession that both of you can get involved and run together. Possibly a Christian ministry or an area of ministry. I have seen couples go on evangelism together continually to the level where soul winning and evangelism became the passion of both couples. I mean, find something that you can share and work together from leisure to spiritual activity. Then, of course, I have seen couples, involved in running a church together. It makes all the difference. I mean, I have seen couples run farming and agricultural concern together. Find something that you can work on together so that it will keep you, seeing one another, interacting with one another, connecting with one another at a deeper level. That is what will make you to understand one another's word at a deeper level. And I'm talking about three different levels: emotionally, spiritually, and physically. It is necessary for you to get connected with one another on that platform, so that at the end of the day, your marriage will be exemplary. Your marriage will be something that other people will copy. Your marriage will be a place where, a reference point to young people that are coming up in their marital lives. I bless the name of the Lord for your life. May God give you all it takes to know one another at a deeper level. I've discovered over time that most couples that parted ways in their marital life, it is simply because they got disconnected somewhere in the middle and they started, chasing life on different platforms, doing their own selfish things in their own selfish ways. Before you knew it, a gully developed at the middle. But in your own case, as you put all these things I've mentioned in place, you discover that, you begin to walk closer and closer together and you begin to walk as one. That is the vision. Walk as one with your spouse. May God bless you.